guess I've been trying to find all these different gyms. And World's gym is closed. I don't know which gym to go to.
McFit is normally
He's here
open.
In Germany, but you're on base two hours away.
McFit is always open. That's 24 hours.
We got to introduce you real quick. This is Calvin.
How you doing?
He's a client, but I got to say he's my boy because this guy works his butt off. I met him Guantanamo Bay, Cuba, one of the most prestigious military base. It was an honor. I think we were the first supplement company. Yeah. I'm the only pro to ever go there. And we were invited there for an event, and we were just there to show the troops some love.
And just hit it off after that. Yeah. Did what, 3-day training?
Yep.
Came up every day.
Trained. It worked every day. We worked hard. I trained with these troops, and he was one of the guys that stood out. I mean, there was a lot of strong soldiers there, but he was, you know, by far, you know, stronger, more developed physique-wise than everyone else. And he was like, afterwards, like, what about? Yeah. I trained for a show. You know, what do you think, man? Think you could get me looking better? I was like, yeah, man, you got potential. So he does physique. He's almost classic physique, though.
That's what everybody said.
He's got legs.
That's what everybody said.
I'm glad you changed the color of your pants, too.
I know, right?
This is literally all I had left. So let's go to the gym.
And what they did is when supplements come in, they scan them for how high the content is with certain ingredients.
Yeah.
Because what they're saying is the Surgeon General for here is saying that the level of content that we have for certain ingredients is way higher than they wanted for the Germans to be or whatever.
Yeah.
So.
That's crazy.
I ordered some stuff. It came in. And what happened is it didn't have the customs form on it. So they flagged it. So I had to take it to the customs department, and she was like, open it up. So I opened it up, and it was one of those sales that ProSupps had for like Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And it's like two boxes of just like
the Black Friday sale.
Yeah. And she's like, open it up, and she's like, yep, you can't have this, 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 and this.
What?
And they dumped it right there. I was
carnitine.
So everything. I had protein.
Carnitine is... I give that to like a little kid, 8-year-old. It's fine. But you guys can't have a lot of fat burners here in Germany. Mm-hmm. And when I say you guys, like, you're American, but he's stationed here. So. All right, guys. So we're here at FIBO. And, you know, obviously a lot of YouTubers like these epic collabs. And sometimes you're collabing with people you don't know. And it's cool. And I see all of the YouTubers doing that. But the real me... I like to meet interesting people. I don't care how many subscribers you have. And, you know, if you have a ton of subscribers and I don't really care for you, I don't need to collab with you. So today is very interesting because this is really how my expos usually roll. I did a contest on Snapchat and I made a dare to all the Germans out there. I said, the first person to show up to my booth, me being Texan, and we wear cowboy boots occasionally, said the first German person to show up wearing cowboy boots, you get to work out with me. Well, lo and behold, a couple dudes showed up with boots on, one right after the other, but the first place dude that showed up, he was wearing cowboy boots, never wore cowboy boots in his life, paid for the cowboy boots all the way from Holland. So we're back to meet him in the gym. I hope he don't have cowboy boots on.
There he is. I'm sitting there talking about you.
Wow.
How are you doing?
Hi, great, thank you.
Great. Alright, so you got
workout clothes on? Yes.
Okay. Cool. Thank you for waiting, by the way. We got stuck in traffic. You put my hotel right next to the expo.
I cannot get you out there. I saw the one you gave.
We got my main man, one of my clients, military. A lot of history with this guy. We got the contest winner. And then we got the contest winner and my followers, videographer. So he's already trying to one-up me, you know, because obviously I got one of the best professionals in the game shooting right now. His pump. But let's get this thing started. We'll be right back. go be a diabetic, I need to warm up a little bit more.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, sometimes our muscles, we get cramped. You said your blood sugar's been high all day, so you're dehydrated probably right now too. So we got to do that every day. So let's warm up next time. Let's add the band here. I like to see guys with a more fluid pull-up rather than just getting it up there. So we're going to work on it. I don't train my blood sugar high. I always use insulin to make a correction, and I want to bring my blood sugar down. You know, because when you train your blood sugar high, you're not as open to your
stomach right now.
Oh yeah. Take your time, you know. So why don't you use a little insulin to bring it down? Oh, you did? Oh, okay.
did you come here? If you don't want to, the feel is just so strong. Just give me one more.
Problems that diabetics run into upon many is when they train, their blood sugar rises. When your blood sugar is high, you don't absorb nutrients, so you feel very weak, feel very tired, you can get very lightheaded, and in his case, he always gets stomach issues, and it causes like all sorts of acid reflux in his stomach, so it's hard to train. And then when you're low blood sugar, which I was earlier, sometimes it's a little bit more simple, you just eat sugar. But if you have really low blood sugar, you have to just cut the workout completely. There's all sorts of complications, and it's crazy that my guy who won the contest and wore the boots is actually type 1 like me. Because, you know, the truth is, it's kind of, there's not a lot of type 1s out there that I do run into all over the world, but it's crazy that he, you know, saw that on Snapchat this year. So, but he's gonna finish this last workout, damn it. And it's great. I feel this on my lower back more than deadlifts. And that's the reason, I mean, obviously deadlifts you're doing for a lot of different reasons. But don't forget your back extensions. And you can do this elite exercise for back extensions with the front raise. Great for low back strength, and it will increase your deadlift. All right, so a lot of times, you know, these up and coming elite physique guys, they wanna pose off. And sometimes guys won't do it. I don't care. I'm off season. I don't mind. This guy, look how conditioned he is. So we're going to do a little pose off here. And we'll see if bulk mode Poston can hang with. What's your name?
Andre.
This is his show?
2 weeks out.
2 weeks out. 2 months. No, 2 years out. So, fantastic workout. I have to say, one of my favorites, definitely one of my most memorable. Every time I travel, it's just, I meet someone special, some special event happened. It's been a great time, but today, you know, it's great. I had the contest, I met one of the guys who follows me on Snapchat. You know, I've snapped him back before. He won the boots contest. He wore the boots to the boot. It was just a lot of fun, but you know, he kicked butt in the workout. Come to find out, he's type 1 diabetic. The workout with Calvin, you know, I met Calvin at one of my first appearances off overseas, Guantanamo Bay. I was the first person, IFBB pro actually, to ever be invited to Guantanamo Bay to train the troops. I met him here in Germany. He's stationed here in Germany as a US soldier. So, random workouts sometimes, as you guys know out there, sometimes you have the best workouts when you least expect it. Thank you for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more. And as always, love you guys.